Let's get this underway. Okay. So we are here today for the first game of week 11, if my calculations are correct. We have an exciting match between Muffin Men and Team Priapism. Very similar records. Muffin Men or Priapism just has not played a game yet, that they are making up later this week. Muffin Men are 3-7 at the eighth spot in the standings, but again, it's a very, very close race for that. Those last couple playoff spots. So every win definitely helps, especially this late into the season. And then we have Team Priapism on the other side, who's also just right in the race at 2-7. I think only a game, maybe like a game and a half back. So like actual positions don't 100% matter. Muffin Men come in with a 5.7 points per game. Team Priapism coming in with 6.6 points per game, which is drastically improved as the storyline of the season once they added Vigran. And Muffin Men have 33% music questions correct, I believe, with six questions asked. So we'll see if maybe that plays a role this week. And then Team Priapism has an 86% college question sports correctness with, I believe, seven questions asked. So they're doing pretty solid on that. And then last week, Muffin Men defeated their arch rivals in Don't Blow It, 8-5, in a very contentious victory, I'm sure. And Priapism did not play last week. So let's get into the game. Disclaimer, this is probably going to be a difficult game, so just take that information heading in.
All right.
Just get my buzzer ready. Make sure you guys can hear it. You guys can hear that?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. So, first category,
Yeah,
CFB.
everybody off mute here.
What?
Everybody off mute.
I mean, they're not sharing a room, so it doesn't 100% matter. So, yeah. Okay, CFB bowl game. So this is about, it's going to be asking about bowl games specifically. Would anyone like to double?
For double us, actually. Vigran, are you confident?
No, because they can just get so obscure.
Okay. All right, no double.
Okay, no double from either side. Muffin Men will be answering first every single round. So this is for Muffin Men. Which bowl game included the following matchups? 2021, it was Ole Miss versus Indiana. 2020, it was Minnesota versus Auburn. 2019, it was Iowa versus Mississippi State.
So it's a pretty good bowl.
I have. I think I know what it is.
Oh,
I think this is. I think this is the Outback Bowl.
See, I don't. I think it's better than that.
Because
Like, we've
we've
never.
no, because we've made fun of Miller that Northwestern always make that, and they would always play an SEC team. What were you thinking, though?
No, I mean Outback Bowl came. It came to my mind right away. But
Trying to think of Ole Miss, but like Ole Miss, I mean Indiana was decent last year. Ole Miss
I
was
usually feel
okay.
like the Outback Bowl is like 16 versus 22, but I guess maybe this. I'm fine with Outback Bowl, honestly. It came to both of our minds.
All right, Outback Bowl final answer.
Outback Bowl final answer is correct.
There we go,
This
Mars.
is the Outback Bowl. So that is point on the board with the first question for Muffin Men. Let's move on to Team Priapism's question. Which bowl game included the following matchups? 2021, it was Northwestern versus Auburn. 2020, Alabama versus Michigan. 2019, Kentucky versus Penn State.
I think it's I think it's the Citrus Bowl, guys.
Cool with that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fine with me.
Citrus Bowl, final answer.
Citrus Bowl, final answer. That is correct.
Shit.
To a hot start from both teams.
That nice came to my mind, too, for, like, no reason whatsoever. Good job.
Okay. So, 100% correct on this first category. Let's get into our first niche category. This is a niche for Team Priapism. Would Muffin Men like to double? No. Not doubling. Okay. So, this question is for Muffin Men. Which car brand houses all of their electric cars under the ID series? So all of their electric cars are ID something. Like that is how they identify their electric cars. This is a car brand.
It's not Tesla.
No.
I'm trying to think how many brands even have electric cars right
now. That's what I was thinking. A lot of the, I think a good amount of the U.S. companies do. U.S. car brands.
You know what it is.
I don't know why BMW came to mind, but I don't know if they have an electric car.
What, like Audi? Do they have an electric car?
I like don't think so.
Yeah, I mean,
no. I don't know.
All right,
we'll go BMW final answer.
BMW final answer is incorrect. 30 seconds for Team Priapism.
Volkswagen final answer.
Volkswagen final answer is correct.
Oh, like Connor.
Yes, it is Volkswagen.
Hey, good okay. job.
That's a solid get for Team Priapism. I did not think that was going to be super easy. Maybe it offered some thought. But for Team Priapism, this question, this car brand houses or uses the label E or e-tron to indicate their electric models. All of them have E or e-tron in the name of their electric models.
Audi, final answer.
Audi, final answer. Just, Sean is crushing it right now.
By the way, Sean.
Insane.
Big electric car guy.
Yeah, big electric car guy, apparently. Good for the environment. Love to see that.
Ooh, that makes sense, though, because they have, like, the A. Like, their normal models are the A, so then the E kind of makes
sense. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Sure. Yep. I definitely would have used that line of thinking. okay, moving on to the NBA. Would anyone like to double this?
I think...
Yeah, should we?
I think we should. Did college bowl games count as a sports category as well, right?
Yes, that counted as a sports category, yeah. So this would be the second.
I think we should double this.
Okay, cool. Double.
Okay, doubling it for Team Priapism. Again, this first question is for Muffin Men. Since 2000, who is the only player over the age of 30 to win the MVP award?
2000.
I think LeBron is too basic. I mean, how old was Shaq when he won it?
I don't think he's won one since he was young. There's no way he won when he played like for the Heat or anything, right?
No, he won it on the Lakers.
And yeah, so then no.
He could have been 30. I mean, Did he ever win it?
No, I don't think he ever won MVP. I could be wrong. I don't know. Oh, well.
Steph Curry?
No, I don't think he's even 30. Or he might be 30 now, but I don't think he won every point. Let's just go with, what did you say, Cal?
First need an comment? Answer.
LeBron, final answer.
LeBron, final answer. That is incorrect. 30 seconds for...
I think it might be Steph Curry.
This is all you.
That's what I was thinking too.
I'm trying to milk the time here so I can think more about it. But that's the best one I've got. Steph Curry, final answer.
Okay. I'm gonna buzz it wrong initially, mostly because I don't know. The answer was Steve Nash. I just got to double check if Steph Curry is an answer. If he is, I'll accept that because I. Let me just double check.
For Sharon said he just looked.
Is it right?
It's not right.
He wasn't. Okay. Yeah. So then, yeah. Okay. So that, yeah, the answer was just Steve Nash. So yeah, no other individual has won it over the age of 30 since 2000. So still just a 2-point game. This is for a double and to extend their lead for Team Priapism. Since 2000, only one player has won Defensive Player of the Year 4 times. Name that player.
I think I know it, but I'm trying to think of other people who it could be. Okay. Do you guys have any thoughts or no?
No.
Nope. Okay. I'm going to go Dwight Howard, final answer.
Dwight Howard, final answer is incorrect. 30 seconds for Muffin Man.
When we can't phone a friend, can we?
No, you can't. Not in a seal.
I have like 3 answers, and you tell me what you like best. Yeah. Joakim Noah, Kawhi Leonard, and Rudy Gobert. Yao Ming came to my mind.
I like Joakim Noah, honestly.
I like Joakim
Rudy Gobert.
Dude, 4 times is a lot. No, Joakim Noah only won it 1 time.
I'm going to need an answer.
Rudy Gobert.
Rudy Gobert. Incorrect. I'm pretty sure he hasn't done it 4 times. This is Ben Wallace. Okay. During the early 2000s Pistons era.
Yeah.
When they were just crushing it on defense.
Did you give Priapism another point? Because then they get 1 in the first category and then both car ones and then 1 here.
They didn't get Steve Nash.
No, we got 1.
Oh, my bad. Yeah.
Wallace is just crushing it today.
Yeah,
just,
good try, Wallace.
Just on point with everything.
At least I knew Ben Wallace.
Good thing you're playing.
Moving on. So no double, unfortunately, there for Team Priapism, but still a lot of game left to accrue a lead or for Muffin Men to close the gap. This is called Scramble for Africa. This is going to be about, like, imperialism, so... You'll see when the questions are here. Would you like to double Muffin Man?
Nope.
No. Okay. Which European nation attempted to colonize Ethiopia in the 1890s?
Okay. I have a couple answers, but do you have any idea, Mars?
No.
Okay. It's kind of a crapshoot. I feel like sneakily... the Netherlands were all over this. So I'm going to go
with what you want. Yeah.
I'm going to go with the Netherlands final answer.
Netherlands final answer is incorrect. 30 seconds.
Where's Ethiopia?
So either you Africa.
Know, I know, like, West or East Coast, or like where? I was thinking, like, I don't know, France, Spain, or Britain. Like,
yeah, I was thinking Spain.
Yeah. I'm with Spain.
Spain.
Okay.
Final answer.
Spain final answer is incorrect. This is going to be Italy. Italy attempted to colonize them very hard and then got beat by tribal nations. Yes, bad luck for them. So no points there. We'll go into Team Priapism's question. Which European nation colonized Cameroon from 1884 to 1916?
I think it's France. Off the top of my head.
Yeah, I don't. I kind of like that answer too.
You guys like it, then I'm fine with it.
Okay, France final answer.
France final answer is incorrect.
Oh, shit. So did I. Oh, shit.
Yeah, I saw your mouth, Mars.
I mean, with like the UK, with the UK, or like, I mean, they feel like they colonize a lot, but I feel like that's such an easy answer.
I like Portugal. Dude, I also think the Netherlands could be good.
Fuck.
Spain?
I don't know. What do you think? What do you, you probably know better than I do.
Five.
Go.
The Netherlands, final answer.
Netherlands, final answer again. Does not do it for them this time. This is Germany.
Germany. Well, okay. It wasn't even on our tongue.
Good attempts from both sides. I guess history is just not going to fly for this matchup. So we'll go into Dave Matthews Band. Okay, this is a niche.
Finally. Gee.
Yes, they've offered it so many times, and I think it's gotten blocked like for five
great category.
Gotten blocked 10 weeks in a row. So.
Yeah. So this is for Muffin Men. I guess if Priapism wanted to use their phone a friend on their question, they could, but might be a little bit difficult with audio. So you're gonna hear like 15 minutes of the intro of it. Sorry, not 15 minutes. 15 seconds of the intro, like of a Dave Matthews Band song, and you're gonna have to identify the album it's off of.
Oh fuck! Okay.
Okay.
Hard, shit.
But sure.
Okay. So, what album would you find this song on?
Whiskey and the Groove
Got King. Okay, one sec. That was incredibly loud. Sorry, could you just repeat that? I'm just gonna.
Big Whiskey and the Groove Got King.
Yes, that is correct. This is Big Whiskey and the Groove Got King. Don't know what a Groove Got is, but that's the title of the album. Okay. So, closing the gap on their own niche. The song was You and Me. For Team Priapism, I'm only going to play this once for so for Team Priapism, I'm not going to play it again when it's your guys' question. So just make sure you listen to it now. What album would you find this song on?
I think I have heard that before. I only know like the older albums, I don't think the last song was an older album.
I think that the song was Crash Into Me, but I don't know what album.
It wasn't Crash Into Me.
You sure?
Yeah.
I got no idea, guys. It's all you.
Yeah, no.
John, name Crash an older album.
I think it's the second one. I think it's called Crush. I don't think it's the first album. I think the second one's called Crush. We can just go with that. Crush, okay, final answer.
Crush, final answer is what I'm going with. That is incorrect.
All right. I believe it is Busted Stuff. The song is Where Are You Going?
Where Are You Going? That's what it was.
Is that a final answer?
Busted Stuff, yeah, final answer.
Busted Stuff, final answer is correct. I believe it is an older album. I don't know. I think
2002.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, so tied the game up on their niche. Both teams showing some mastery over their niches, so that's how they're supposed to go. My team should take that advice. And this is also a niche for Team Priapism. Would Muffin Men like to double?
No.
No. Okay, Forgotten College Basketball Stars. This forward played for Gonzaga in the early 2000s and was a finalist for the Naismith and Wooden Award during the 2005-06 season before being drafted third overall by the Charlotte Bobcats.
Oh, I have one guess, but I think it was too far back for him. Let me keep thinking.
I was hoping it's going to be like Jimmer for that.
That's what I was thinking.
How about
that? Try to think. If you have nothing, I have an answer, but.
I'm also trying to think of like who would have been drafted that high by the Bobcats.
I think might be wrong if there's another player, but.
Growth pinstripe jersey.
All right.
I mean, could we phone a friend? Like, would anyone know this?
I don't think maybe Ross, but yeah. all right, we'll go with, I think this is way too early for him, though, but Kelly Olynyk, final answer.
Kelly Olynyk, final answer is incorrect.
I don't know anybody else that went there.
Adam Morrison, final answer.
Adam Morrison, final answer.
Damn.
That's Adam Morrison. Who is a good question because he did nothing after being in college.
He had a mean mustache, though.
Yeah, he did have a mean mustache. That's the one thing he had going for him. So that's going to be a point for Priapism on their niche. Okay. So still a very tight game, and most points have been obtained through niches outside of the first question. So we'll see if which team can pull away in their with their not niche mastery. This forward / center played for Ohio State in the early 2010s and made first team All-American honors both years that he played before being drafted 21st overall by the Boston Celtics.
Jared Sullinger, final answer.
Jared Sullinger, final answer is correct. Okay. Go. So still a 2-point game, but often men do have their double. They still do have one of their niches coming up. And there's a lot of game left, so definitely not over by any means. Companies named after names. So these are going to be companies named after people's names, and you're going to have to identify something about them. Eli Lilly, Merck, Bristol-Myers Squibb are all companies in what industry?
Pharmaceutical.
Yeah. No, it is. It is 100%. 100% is.
Okay. Pharmaceutical, final answer.
Pharmaceuticals, final answer is correct. This is pharmaceuticals. I would have accepted biotechnology as well.
Healthcare would have been too broad, maybe?
Yeah, healthcare would have been a little bit weird because, yeah. For Team Priapism, Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Huntington Ingalls all sell what type of product? Just very general answer is what I'm looking for.
Like aerospace, or is that not?
Yeah, I think it's got to be aerospace. Like they make planes and fighter pilot, like
they sell planes.
I mean, yeah, I mean, I know Lockheed Martin has like planes, like defense. I don't know. Do you know what Northrop, the other ones are?
I think they do some stuff. I think Northrop Grumman makes the same sort of stuff.
Okay, so aerospace.
Would you accept that, Neil? Is that like what you're looking for?
I would accept that as an answer, yes.
All right. I think
aerospace products.
Let's say aerospace, final answer.
Aerospace, final answer. That is incorrect.
It's defense companies, right?
Yeah, I would say defense.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know how else to put it. I think it's just defense, right? I don't know what else.
They're like defense contractors.
Yeah, national defense.
What do we say? Rockets or defense?
I feel like he'll give it to us, right? I think it's defense.
I honestly thought he was going to give it to them for aerospace.
I think it's
say defense.
Defense.
Final answer.
Defense. Final answer. I will take that.
Bro, is defense a type of product? That doesn't fit the question at all.
The way that they describe, like, I'm going to accept defense because I, like, they described it in a way that it was meant to be, like, arms. And
okay, defense is not a type of product, though.
If Northrop Grumman and Huntington Ingalls also sell planes to the military or whatever, like, that should be accepted.
That's not what they're known for.
But they're specifically
known for arms. But they all sell what type of product? They sell that type of product.
No, they sell other things. They're defense.
In terms of, in general, like, you can look it up.
That's not what the question is.
If Huntington Ingalls and Northrop Grumman both also sell planes.
Okay.
I'll accept that. You can look it up. Like if they
that
sell
was my
fighter
question.
Jets. But overall, arms is a better descriptor of what they sell in terms of a type of product when I said general. Aerospace was too narrow in what I asked.
Northrop Grumman sells manned aircrafts. They build manned aircrafts. And I'm looking up Huntington Ingalls.
No, it's asking what industry they're in. It's not like
It says they sell what type of product. It does not say what industry they're in.
It says type of product, not a specific product.
Okay. Aerospace is a type of product.
And wait, the way that I accepted defense, it was in arms because defense generally means arms. That is pretty clearly indicated. Especially when you're using it in reference to companies. defense products. That is a type of product.
Could be defense contracting, like could be anything. Whatever.
Yes, but they said defense products.
That is defense contracting.
So I will be giving the point to Muffin Men. It's a tied game. We're moving on to round eight. This is the niche for Muffin Men, Lord of the Rings. For Muffin Men, the question, because they cannot double. Team Priapism also has their phone a friend left if you would like to use it on your question. Two animals are shown in the scene where the hobbits enter the Inn of the Prancing Pony. Name one of the two animals. They're like shown in the overview scene of them entering.
Name one of them? Okay.
Yep.
A pig. Final answer.
A pig is incorrect.
What?
Other side.
Damn. We just guessed. I have no idea. Horse?
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna guess.
Horse, final answer.
Okay, I'm gonna take horse as a final answer. That is incorrect. They showed a cat and a ferret.
Oh, there's
they showed a ferret peeking out of somebody's jacket, and then they also showed a cat just kind of lounging around.
That was
okay. So for Team Priapism, Treebeard tells Merry and Pippin that this type of animal climbs up and tickles him. He's specific, like he says this type of animal does that.
Climbs up and tickles him.
Is it like a monkey, maybe? I don't know.
No. I don't think so.
I do kind of like monkey as an answer.
I don't think that's it. Like, I don't think there are monkeys in that forest.
I don't know. I've never seen Lord of the Rings.
What about like a squirrel?
Yeah, I could say that. I mean, that would just be like me. This animal climbs up and tickles him. Oh, I can't remember.
What about a cat?
I don't think it would be cat back-to-back questions.
You can say squirrel, maybe. Okay. I don't really think that's right, but we can go with it.
Squirrel final answer.
Squirrel final answer is incorrect.
Dude, I have no idea. This is so hard. I think the timer is. A chipmunk. Final answer.
Chipmunk final answer is incorrect. This is field mice. I would have just accepted mice. He says that mice run up his trunk. Yes.
That was hard.
Damn.
Okay. Tied game. We have two rounds left, and you have to use your double at some point in the game. So either round 9 or 10, and then you guys both have your phone a friend available if you would like to use it. Okay. This is the NFL. Would anyone like to double?
Yeah.
We'll double this one. For the next doubling. One, their niche, right?
Oh, no, the last category is a non-niche.
Okay.
That is left over.
Yeah, I think we just double here. Yeah, we'll double.
Double in here to pull away a little bit towards the end of the game. This question is for Muffin Men. This NFL team originated in Chicago, moved to St. Louis prior to settling in their current location.
It's the Cardinals.
Ah, yeah.
Right, yeah. All right, Cardinals final answer.
Cardinals final answer is what I'm taking.
Ours is let's fucking correct. Go.
Let's go.
Two that's points. To pull away slightly. That is a big get for the double.
I was going to say Rams.
For Team Priapism. This current NFL team originated as the Dallas Texans and before moving to where they are now. And then we're also the first team to join the AFL.
I knew my guess would be my guess is the Broncos. That's my guess off the top of my head.
I think it would be too obvious to be the Houston, right? To be Houston.
It's not the Houston Texans. The only other guess I would have would be Tennessee because the Houston Oilers moved to Tennessee. But I think it's the Broncos. I'm just trying to think of teams that I know are AFL teams.
Yeah, I'm cool with the Broncos.
Okay, Broncos final answer.
Broncos final answer is incorrect. 30 seconds for Muffin Man. I think Titans now.
I was going to say Houston Oilers, but Oh, it says this current NFL. I see.
I like the Titans. They're in the AFL, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I don't hate that at all. Let's go with that.
Sure. Fine. Titans final answer. Yeah.
Titans final answer to pull an extra point away is incorrect. This is the Kansas City Chiefs, which made it as Dallas Texans. First team to join the AFL officially.
Yeah, I was thinking that for the last question for a second. I don't know why I didn't think of it here. That was dumb. And we could have called Tyler.
All right. Yeah, true. Well, we have our phone a friend. So let's
Both teams have their phone a friend for this final round. A doozy cartoons. Definitely not out of reach if Team Priapism sweep this category. They could tie the game and send it into overtime. So four Muffin Men. Definitely a big point if they get it, they win. Let's get into it. Sort these shows from oldest to newest in terms of premieres, when they first premiered. Ben 10, Codename Kids Next Door, and then Foster's Home for Imaginary Kids.
I haven't heard of any of these besides Ben 10.
You haven't heard of Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends?
No.
I mean, Ben 10, isn't that like a comic strip or no?
No, I mean, they make a show. I think it was a comic thing, but...
These are all so obscure. Do you know anyone who would know this? Like, these are all...
No. No idea. Nobody. No. Have you heard of these shows?
I mean, I've heard of... I mean, I think Foster's Home for Imaginary... It's a total crapshoot. I have never heard of
Codename. I don't know why. I like Codename, then Ben 10, then Foster's. For no reason.
I like Ben 10 the newest.
As the newest? Okay, so we'll go... Should we go Codename, Foster's, Ben 10?
Yes.
All right, we'll go Codename, Foster's, Ben 10, final answer.
Codename, Foster's, Ben 10. Believe that is correct. Yes, Codename. Kids Next Door, Adam Foster's Boy, Home for Imaginary Friends, Ben 10, just Ben 10. These are all Cartoon Network shows. I'm surprised that they were obscure.
Cartoon Network was kind of for the weird kids, Neil.
Okay, that's a backhanded slap, I guess. Yeah. I mean, shit. Okay, so that does put the game out of reach, but for point-keeping purposes, Team Priapism... Few shows from oldest to newest. Chowder, The Marvelous Misadventures of Flapjack, and My Gym Partner's a Monkey.
Fuck are these?
Man, seen these? Shit.
Oh, I don't know. Gym Partner's a Monkey. Oh, I watched that so many times. Love that show.
Okay.
I don't know. what do you want to say?
I don't know. This is
just do it in order. It doesn't fucking matter.
Marvelous Misadventures of Flapjack, Chowder, My Gym Partner's Monkey, final answer.
Okay. Probably have jotted these down. Let me double check what the actual answer was. Could you just repeat it for me?
Quickly? The middle, first, the last.
Middle, first, last. Okay. Let's see. Once my PowerPoint loads. Do, 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 do. It's not loading. Okay. So middle, first, last. That's correct. Wait.
Nice.
Middle. First. No, that's incorrect. Sorry. Shouldn't have raised your
hand. I was going to go middle, last, first anyway. So.
Okay. Middle, last.
Middle, last, first.
Middle, last, first.
Yeah, I was already...
No, that is incorrect. It's My Gym Partner's a Monkey, so it's last, middle, or last, first, middle. That is the correct answer. So 8-5 game, no phone of friends used.